Yo, I go by the name of Gillie the King.
And I'm Wallo 267.
And check us out on Drink Champs. And it's just like that. You know what I mean? And we bringing that butter to make the beans stuck.
Then you got a game, Drink Champs.
Give me a nutter.
Can't fuck with that. And it's just like that.
Boom.
Right.
Hopefully it is where it should be. This is your boy, N.O.R.E.
What up, it's DJ EFN.
And this is motherfucking Militainment, Crazy War Radio / Drink Champs. Make some noise! Now, by the way, this is not only one of my favorite shows that I've been tuned into, but this is one of my favorite people to follow on social media. When y'all look at Gillie's career, and I look at, you know, his new life, it's a whole new guy. It's a whole new type of brightness, whole new type of aura. When I look at his cousin and the things that they've been through, and I look at their camaraderie, how they joke on each other, and that's how real men could actually, like, you should be able to joke on a real man, and a man should sit there and be that confident right. In himself. So most people will see this relationship and think something else, but they look, these guys, I enjoy seeing them on social media. I got put on to Wallo, which is the weirdest thing how... through my man Deuce, who is out here today. I've been running with Deuce for 20 years. He has never been a fan of nobody and nothing. And he's a super jail dude, and he
super
lives,
jail dude.
Super jail. I'm sorry, that's the way you gotta describe him. He's the only person he posts on social media is Wallo.
I gotta meet him, man.
No, he's coming today. He flew down y'all flew down, but hey, I made sure he flew down as well. One of the toughest dudes I know. But let me just finish bigging y'all up. When I see the karate, and I see how y'all doing, and I see how it's just like the $1 million worth of game on the thing, but it's from two different perspectives. It's like a street perspective, a person who's been in the streets, and a person who had that post. And who y'all are right now is people I sincerely respect.
Love.
You know what I'm saying? I sincerely respect. I love what you're doing. I love the way you guys are doing it. And I want to go through everything, all the emotions. So if y'all don't know who the fuck we talking about, we talking about Wallo, Gillie, motherfucking kid, man, that motherfucking kid.
Yes, sir.
So I want to get that switcher going immediately. Give me a switcher. So I want to, because you guys are real cousins.
Real.
This is real. First
real,
cousins
yeah.
type shit?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Because like... Yo, most of my first cousins, I like, hey, like, how did y'all get along? Yeah. How's this?
I mean, mm-hmm. as youngins, you know, right. we was always, you know, kind of connected as right. far as our personalities.
I was his first rap manager. That's what right. he
the
is.
Fuck out of here.
I was, nigga. I took you to the studio first.
You took me to the studio.
Give me my fucking credit. I was your first manager.
All right, hold on. You were my first fucking manager.
I was, too.
Fuck out of here.
You
look
like you should fucking admit it.
Who took you to the fucking studio?
Capone might have took you to the studio.
He
yo.
Did, and he don't let me forget about
it. But that's your manager.
I was his manager.
Fucking manager.
Capone always lets me know that, nigga, if it wasn't for me, because to be honest, that's a great point, and I want to big Capone up because I never big him up about right. this. Capone had a solo deal. What I came to realize is Capone said he would rather be on a group. In a group, but what I realized is Capone was a lazy motherfucker. Yeah. That's the reason why. Yeah. So, but we gotta keep the props. He did say I want to be in a group. So I gotta give it.
That's
that
what
props.
He did. Okay. He was like, yo, I was your manager. Man, you nice man. We can make this rap shit happen. I'm
listen,
like,
I got all the beats. Right. I went and got the logo. This nigga was going to. I'm dubbing the fucking tapes because this right. is back when we started rapping with niggas. You know
right.
tapes.
Right. Right.
So I would go downtown, steal 100 tapes, dub
wow.
them up
wow.
while this motherfucker somewhere else. I'm passing the tape to the drug dealer wow. niggas I know. Play wow. this. He got a system in his car. Play right. this. He gonna take. Right. And he's saying, damn, they playing our shit. Yeah, I'm wow. your manager, nigga.
Yeah.
I'm manager. The money. I mean, it was a show or two that was done. He ain't know nothing right. about no money. It right. came through me. Yeah. So, you know, the well, manager shit.
Well, then if that's the case, then I managed you before you went to jail. Because if it wasn't for me, you don't want to jail a virgin.
Get the fuck out of here.
Nigga, I got your dick off the shit.
Fuck, crackheads don't count,
come
nigga.
Come on, nigga.
Get the fuck out of here.
You want me to stop playing? Don't make me put you the fuck out.
Don't make me put you the fuck out here.
So what were you doing prior to going to jail?
Well, see, this one, this
robberies,
this
is no fucking.
No, we're not talking about. He's not talking about that. He's not talking about that though. What happened was, I say, cuz, we got to set it off. Now, this is why. And he would say, and this nigga said I was the fuck crazy back then. Mm. I'm reading Rap Pages magazines. Wow. You know, niggas wasn't even reading back then.
What's the guy? Larry Flint owned that.
Listen,
Larry Flint,
yep. I'm reading Rap Pages magazine. So I tell this nigga, I said, yo, we got to get some of this money. Mm. I'm looking at what Master P and them doing. Wow. He don't know who Master P is. So one day I play Master P in the studio, and what did you say?
What song would you play of Master P?
I was paying TRU. TRU.
Okay, okay.
Mobbing through the hood, 6D, who riding up. And what did you say? Go ahead.
Master P, my man, that's my
No, what the fuck did you say? Turn that bullshit off, that nut ass shit. I said, no, cuz, listen, these niggas is getting independent rap money.
But in you guys' defense, in both of y'all's defense, Philly, that, to me, Philly took over. Like the super spitters. Like at one point it was just New York, but I felt like Philly took over that rapping shit real right. serious at one point. Right. So I could see where he's coming from.
Yeah, and at that time, you gotta understand, at that time, the South sound hadn't all the way broken through yet. So
I gotta disagree with you.
No.
What year are we talking about? I'm just saying.
Scarface, shit like that.
Yeah, but no.
In 97, if you was going down South, listen, I ain't gonna lie to you. I used to come home and I used to do like interviews with Angie Martinez. I used to be singing Juvenile and Trick Daddy. And they used to be like, what the fuck is wrong with you? But what happened was I was spending so much time out here that I was coming home with their music, not even knowing I was.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
So but up north, it hadn't penetrated yet.
Absolutely.
So
when P come on and he, this nigga sound like he got to take a shit.
But I'm telling him, I'm telling cuz, right? Now, I'm a hip-hop historian, officially. He hate that, because
No, because you a nigga that put labels on yourself.
No, I'm a hip-hop historian, you nut-ass nigga. Get the fuck out of here.
That's like a smart, that's like a nigga labeling himself smart.
Listen, we can talk about electromagnetic. Whatever we talk about. I'm one of them niggas that know all that. So listen, I tell cuz, and this is what I told him. I said, see, fuck being a rapper, because I looked at New York niggas. I love New York. Mm-hmm. New York the shit. Mm-hmm. But I said New York niggas want to be rappers. South niggas want to start labels.
That's real.
I said, them niggas, I said, nobody gave the South niggas they props. Wow. But them niggas was on some CEO shit when niggas was trying to be workers up north. Wow. I said, the niggas that was, the people that did start labels, Steve Ripkins and them, they had the niggas. They had the Mob Deep. They had the motherfucking Wu-Tang. Mm. So I'm like, and he was like, all right, I dig it with you about that part, cuz. You know what I mean? Then he trying to get you sauced down. He like 40s, though. He like 40s, 0800.
It's the upgrade.
Okay, but that nigga like 40s. He want to rumble and all that shit.
That's how I want to do that. I would have brought
him
rumble.
So I tell, and he agreed with me. I said, listen, I love New York. I love different places. Mm. But them niggas in the South, when you talk about Tony Draper, when you talk about Jay Prince, when you talk about Master P, when you talk about
Luke Skywalker records.
When you talk about all of them niggas was like, we want the real paper. We want ownership.
It really
niggas,
wasn't until Hov came in.
Yeah, Hov came in. Yeah, you're right. And he was able to make his shit. But niggas was like, I just want a record deal. Niggas. So I said, them niggas on some shit, bro.
Right.
And then when you went up some years, when 3-6 Mafia came, them niggas was coming with their labels. They came with labels. We need distribution. Fuck y'all money. Mm. We need distribution. Southwest distribution, all that shit that was going on in the South Houston. Mm. So it was like, I'm telling him, like, yo, we got to get some rap money. We listen to Reasonable Doubt. I used to listen to Reasonable Doubt to that shit, to the tape faded off that motherfucker purpose. So I'm like, yo, we got to do some shit, right? We got to set it off. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? Because it was only like 6-7 rap groups in Philly.
But the truth was, is I wasn't a rapper.
Right.
But I was the better rapper.
Y'all was a group?
Yes, and he knew it.
Oh, so you were
he was Major Figgas. I started Major Figgas.
Listen, change your papers, nigga.
This was the nigga.
Nigga, I used to put you in a tub.
He used to be like,
how the fuck? Regular fucking nigga.
So Ab Lava
was in a different group.
Ab Lava
was in a different group. Spado, the nigga that taught me how to rap.
Yeah, he Dustin
was in
Spade.
A group. No, he was. That was before Dustin Spade. Oh, he was in another group called Lyrical Tears from Nicetown, and I was a fucking hype man at the time. Tupac was a hype man, so don't say no nut shit to me. Don't try to fucking put no smut on my jacket.
Tupac was never no hype.
He was too digital.
Don't try to put no fucking smut on Pac, man. Hold on. Pac was just doing a fucking favor. Don't try to put no fucking smut.
Yeah, I was doing the same thing.
Put no fucking smut. Give me Pac name at this thing. You know how I feel about Pac.
Right now,
you know how I feel about Pac.
Why are you gonna take it away from me?
It doesn't matter. I'm giving you a favor.
I went on stage with my sons one time and sang they shit.
You was a fucking hype man.
You got it in your jacket.
So listen, the whole twist is like, all over different. It was just me and Gil as Major Figgas. Right. Ab was doing his thing, Bump. Dustin was doing it, so everybody was doing it. And then when I went to jail.
And then you had Bianca, right?
Yeah, Bianca. And then
I used
the whole
like
Figgas.
Her a lot. She didn't give me no play.
I brought all of them.
I went to jail. And then that's when the shit, what's his name? But this nigga used to be like, this is whole joint. Wow, man, this ain't no fucking money. I said, yo, it's money, because I'm reading everything. Right. I'm like, yo, this shit is some money. I'm learning about
it. And when y'all signed to Interscope? Or no?
Warner Brothers.
I signed a solo deal with Suave House.
Shout out to Tony Draper.
Shout out to Tony Draper, the best CEO I ever signed.
Oh, word?
The realest CEO I ever signed to in my fucking life.
And he's responsible. He helped a lot of niggas in his rap game.
A lot. Behind the scenes. Behind the scenes.
A lot of big deals. Big money.
Cash money, get their deal.
Yeah, big money.
Yeah.
He's a legend, Tony.
I'll say something.
And then I took the group over to Warner Brothers, Rough Nation, and then Dutch and Spade.
Rough Nation, that was the same people that walked
Chris
up
and Schwartz,
on,
yep.
Chris Schwartz,
yeah. And then
I
Dutch
think
and Spade
was over there too.
Went over to Interscope Entertainment. And Lava went with Drake at the time.
Dre first.
Yeah.
And then Pharrell and Pushy still fucking with them as to
And Dutch and Spade went to Entertainment.
Yeah, I said that.
Oh, you said that, all right.
All right. what you like better? You like being a rapper or being or this?
I'm gonna keep it all the way real. The way the game did a nigga, I appreciate this shit a lot more.
Right?
You know what I mean?
I ain't gonna run. It's a lot easier.
I don't know if I like it better. I just know it's easier. I know I might not like it better, but I know.
Cause it's still that stage feeling.
One thing I know with this shit right here that I'm doing. It can't blackball a nigga.
It's possible.
Yo, shit.
It's possible.
Shit. Let me give you the game about that. We gonna tell you about that shit.
Let me tell you something. These old niggas don't mean what they used to mean.
No.
Just keep it real.
I meant that in a totally different way. When I said black boy,
like
I'm saying with this,
They canceled me 2 weeks ago. Tell them bitches I'm still in.
You got a bunch of.
What camera is love? Tell the cancel culture, them bitches ain't do good enough.
Right. No.
I'm still around like a circle.
Let me tell you something. As long as you
the fuck out of here.
But there is.
You've been canceled when we got off the boat, you bitches.
Don't get it twisted. Yeah. There is a secret mafia in entertainment, period. Not just podcast, but entertainment, period. There is a secret. So as
absolutely.
Long, and to tell you the truth, as long as we're on a certain extent, they ain't gonna fuck
And the platforms are owned by people that can cancel us.
For me, honest. But go ahead, I wanted you, I think I cut you off.
I was telling, this is what Cuz told me when I came home. I ain't even gonna hold you. He said, I ain't gonna poison you, cuz, but I'm gonna let you know there's a lot of fake ass niggas in this industry.
Right. Cause you wanted to get what made you want to get in the industry coming home?
No, it wasn't even the industry. I just was doing my thing on social.
We ain't gonna say no names, but how many niggas we done came across that you said, damn, cuz, everything you say
about 15
be
niggas,
the motherfucking
man.
Truth.
Like niggas and it was
that's
shocking to me. It was shocking to me that niggas that posed to be somebody be clout chasing.
Yeah.
Like they be trying to be because it's two type of relevancies out here. It's relevancy because you got a deal and you're a rapper, you name, and then it's relevancy by the people. The people is the most powerful joint. Mm. So you don't need a cosign. We living in the game now where this all you need for a cosign. That
real.
Phone. Fuck. Fuck. Oh, this big name,
it's
such real. And such. You ain't got to. You can run your shit through through the digital services. Shut up, nigga. You can run your shit through the digital services.
Watch
you can run your shit through the. You
can run your shit.
Don't
shit,
worry about
man.
It. You can run your shit through the digital services where you don't need. Yep. So it used to be, I need a cosign. I need it.
Right.
No. Right. Because the same niggas that are co-signed, they can stop your show.
Right.
But now, them niggas, they powerless because the technology that said,
we create our
fuck
audience,
the middleman.
Once we created our own audience, we became, what's it called, unstoppable.
Yeah, absolutely.
We became unlawful because
absolutely.
I just don't want to abuse that power. I don't want to abuse
it. But we got to be careful to not be too reliable on that technology.
Yeah,
that we don't own that technology.
Right. Yeah, we don't own the actual technology. Absolutely. We don't
own the technology, but let me tell you this. My whole thing is about this. Like, a lot of people be out there, oh, I'm on Instagram, oh, my followers, oh, that data, oh. I'm like, dog, I hope you got what I got, because I know I got 125,000 emails and phone numbers.
Mm-hmm.
I collect data.
Yeah. Right.
So this game is about data. Absolutely. Because nigga be on Instagram. No, Instagram lets you do your thing, get money, but they own the data. The data is where the money at. Not in the followers, oh, they like my picture, oh, they this, that, and third. And like I be telling a lot of people, it's about why is they following? See, a lot of people, like I told this one artist, he was like, you know, because everybody rap right now.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody's
high. Everybody and their mother.
And everybody podcasts right now.
Listen, everybody podcasts, everybody rap. But I say,
rap about it.
I say something.
Everybody got a show now.
Listen.
Everybody, my E-ho, you got a podcast, it's cool. Salute me, ho.
Okay, I like that.
Wait, hold on, I salute you, though.
I salute you.
We're going to get to that.
But what I'm saying is, it's two type of followings, right? And like I tell dude, if we got a link in our bio for Merch or Show, that bitch ringing like a motherfucking bell. Mm. Ding, ding, ding. Mm. If you can't make that link in your bio move, all that shit you got a following, nigga, could you sell 100,000 of merch?
Right. Right. Talk that talk.
Could you do 100,000 in books?
Talk that talk.
Could you talk that talk?
Hold on, wait. Fuck 100,000.
Talk about that movie.
The kids just did 70.
Come on.
talk about the movie, Blood Brothers.
Do an independent movie and drop that bitch and it go get the damn.
Listen, that motherfucker on that link, that rent in that bar for Blood Brothers.
That motherfucker said, goddamn.
He just posted for no reason. Ding, 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 ding. You got the notifications come up.
Goddamn.
This is the link in the bio game. Is your link breakdancing?
Right.
Is you pimping your link?
Right.
Is your link your money maker? Is that the hoe on the street corner for you? If your link ain't rocking, you ain't rocking.
Right. And a lot of motherfuckers going to spend money with motherfuckers that ain't going to sell you nothing. Listen, man, 2 million niggas follow that bitch, man, because she got a fat ass, and a puppy sitting on the fence.
She can't sell
none. She go to OnlyFans. She going double wood on OnlyFans.
Right, double wood.
On OnlyFans, she double wood.
So we don't want to hear about no motherfucking tummy tuck tea.
Not like I go on OnlyFans or anything.
What the fuck
is
going on here?
You be on
OnlyFans. Just expose yourself. OnlyFans, double wood. I'm the only nigga on there.
I see the little nigga in the hood the other day. He said, bitch, you was laughing at me when I was telling you to get my mixtape, but now you're going double wood on motherfucking OnlyFans. I ain't supporting shit. You ain't get my mixtape, bitch. I said, yo, holy moly, it's a game out there.
Yeah.
But this dude's getting OnlyFans right now.
It's changing.
Feet, he's ready to do a feet, John. Just put feet.
Fuck out.
What? That's cool to do your feet. But I said, I ain't taking, he wanted me to take the pictures. I said, no, I ain't doing that. I'm not taking the pictures. But go ahead, ain't nobody gonna say
don't that. Don't you
imagine? Yeah, you know, I'm ready to see you on that part. Different department.
Above the feet,
Yeah, all that shit. Nigga, you wasn't taking feet, Joe.
That was a good one.
He said, I'm gonna put my feet in Jello, put my feet in King. Different type of fetishes. He said, because these dudes got different fetishes, I can make a lot of money. I said, that's a little too spicy. I'm cool on that. I'll pass on that fetish. I ain't with that shit.
I'm gonna let him get away with
that. That was awesome. And you just celebrated a birthday, right? Where did you go, Mexico?
Yeah.
That was awesome.
Nigga turned 49. 49! Happy 49! Nigga 49.
Yeah, this my man. We don't know if he's 47 or 50.
Ain't no fucking
he had a birthday cake on his birthday party. One said 47, the other said 50.
The 47, that's the shit. He did the 47.
50.
He told white baby, I need 47.
No, 47 is rapper age.
That's his rapper joke.
When he on Push Your T album, he's 47.
Gil got motherfuckers that fuck with the Wikipedia. He like 32 on Wikipedia.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, he got.
I ain't gonna forget Wikipedia. Give me an extra year. They tell you I'm 43 right now. I'm 42 right now. I'll be 43, man.
Yeah, so it's safe to say I'm 44. He's 40. He's 42. You're my young boss.
Okay, all right, man.
You younger than Gillie?
Yeah. That Georgia used to watch him up in the tub.
No, you didn't. You didn't watch him up in the tub. You fucking liar.
His mom used to be like, could you watch him? Get your little ass in the tub.
Get the fuck out of here.
I used to change your diapers and all that.
I was your manager, nigga. I burnt you for a couple shows.
That's your question. Could y'all believe that?
I was
that
your manager.
From changing his diapers, which is totally true, to him being my manager.
Who had anything set up? Who set up all the studio shit?
No, because you was a rapper. You grew up your whole life a fucking rapper.
Did you hook him up with Cash Money?
Fuck no.
No, no, I'm trying to get hooked up with Cash. I'm still trying to find Baby. That's one of my favorite rappers.
He baby dick hoes.
Listen, he's a hater. He's adored by him. He's a fucking hater.
I've never heard nobody say that before.
That's one of my favorite niggas. He won't try to say
Wait, you said it different now.
Oh.
First you said favorite rapper.
No, he's in my rap.
He's dying to be a dick host.
Get the fuck out of here. He's a fuck. No, he's mad. Disgruntled employee because Baby burnt you and told you to get the fuck out of here. Took your plug, missus, and said, get your nut ass out of here. You don't even fucking matter. Okay, stop disrespecting Stunner Nick. He gonna try to tell me that Stunner Nick. Put some fucking respect on Stunner Nick. And when I see him, I'm taking a picture with him and I'm gonna write some bullshit under the caption like he gonna sign me. What the fuck is you talking about?
Just for the record, first of all,
Baby
burnt
you. Baby treats
you
like a nut.
I put out multiple diss records.
Alright.
Multiple diss records. Nigga, you ain't never hear me say a nigga played with no money of mine, nigga. So don't give a fuck what you said. Don't put that motherfucking smut on my jacket, nigga. You ain't never known a nigga to play with no money of mine, man. Come on, man.
Baby ain't give you an NBA basketball check.
No, he gave me a fake drink that bounced.
It bounced. Well then.
He gave all of us the Brian Williams checks.
Wait a minute. I remember hearing this slightly.
Before you start, shout out to you, Stunner, man. We got to connect. We going to do some big things together. Fuck this nigga.
I'm dying. Look at this dick. Shout out to you, Stunner. I don't even know you, but I'm dying to step out.
You know why I respect that? Because dads be like, fuck Suge Knight, and Corrupt be like, Suge Knight is my man.
Right.
Like, as brothers, y'all can have a difference of opinion. But let's get back to this.
As brothers, I beat him the fuck up.
Number one, Stunner. No, you won't. You said
that. Let's get back to this bounce check.
I think his son gave me a bounce check before.
Okay, for what?
Because he knew he was a nut ass nigga.
No, but no. First of all, artist on your first time around, you got that motherfucking Brian Williams check.
I ain't never get a bounce check in my life.
I did. I was in the bank. I'm gonna keep it all real. I was in the bank arguing with the motherfucking teller, like Pinky. She came out. She said, "Sorry, sir, there's no money in that account on anything." I said, "Love." I said, "What?" I said, bitch, that's Cash Money Records.
That's when he was a check fan. Again.
She like,
you ain't say back that ass up?
No, she said, no money in it. I left out the bank on anything I love. I called Stunner. I said, dog, I just left out the bank, man. Bitch in the bank telling ain't no money in that account. That bitch
tripping. She tripping.
That nigga said, oh, call Yolanda. What? I said,
Yolanda.
No, Yolanda was the one who gave the Cash Money checks out.
Oh.
She worked for Cash Money. He gave me a Brian Williams check.
Oh, that's a personality.
Put the water in.
So,
damn, we just drink champs. We ain't anticipating somebody just drinking water.
Leave any water
in. I
apologize. I'll just start drinking.
I don't care.
Yeah. There you go. Fucking nut. Some fucking water. This drink champs. You disrespecting the
game. Drink me anything. It don't just mean drink. What the fuck you mean?
This is drink.
Drink water champs. I got it. I'm starting to drink water champs. And we're going to have all the different bottles of water on the joint. Fuck that. We're going to break this down. We're going to bust it up. We're going to get the IP on that.
So what happened when you called in Yonder?
She sent the check.
Oh, she sent the check. So it got corrected.
Yeah, that was
correct. Oh, come on.
Yeah, baby, number one.
I'm gonna tell you, that's why I'm with you. I don't judge a person based off other people's opinion on people.
Mm-hmm.
All this crazy shit that people ever said about Birdman, I have never seen that done all around me or to me. The man actually, you know. But I'm not saying this didn't happen. But so what was y'all discrepancies at the Cash Money? What made you want to leave?
No, only thing.
The bounce check?
No. Because one thing I can never say about Stunner is he paid any money he ever owed me.
Collins said that.
DJ
Collins said that.
That's never no discrepancy I had against Stunner. You feel what I'm saying? I'm just saying it was just too much dick eating around that joint, man. And I'm just, we men, bruh. Right. Just because you got $100 million, that don't mean you better than me, man. I mean, God just blessed you to have $100 million.
Right.
You get cancer the day of tomorrow, nigga, and you this incurable. You can't take $100 million in a U-Haul truck to your motherfucking gravesite behind you.
Right.
So at the end of the day, I look at niggas like, that's why Tony Draper, when we met, we was like damn near like brothers.
And that was prior to you meeting Birdman?
Yeah, absolutely. You must have
tried to compare Birdman relationship to Tony Draper.
I didn't, but I just, you know, when you think a motherfucker one way and then you get around a nigga and you like, man, this nigga ain't nothing like they say he is, man. Nothing like he betrayed to me, and it ain't no disrespect to him. It's just, that's just how I felt. You feel what I'm saying? Like, and it's man, it's proof. Like, and every, all the niggas that came in the game with him had to sue him to get their money. So that just, you know, that shit speak for itself.
And that's where you and Lil Wayne caught smoke?
No, me and Lil Wayne caught smoke because he just dissed me on a song called Problem Solver. We was cool. I didn't understand it. You know what I mean? Like,
you sure he dissed you? Or you No.
I'm 100.
Let's hit his bars. What was these bars? How they
Gillie,
went?
You don't want to fuck with me.
No, he said Gillie. Yeah. Oh, no, it's Gillie. You thought it was going to be subliminal?
Wait a minute. It's kind of tough. You went way too fast. Hold on. Say the bar again?
It's a song called Problem Song.
No, but I need you to say the ball.
Gillie, man, you don't want to fuck with me. The gunna be burkin' and irkin' and twerkin' and some shit he said like that.
You had not took a shot at him.
No.
You might have said you wrote his rhymes
Nothing.
You said you wrote his rhymes
nothing.
After that.
Nothing. Dog, when that shit happened, two niggas from Philly called me. When the song came out called Problem Song.
Gillie don't want to fuck
And they said, yo, you and Wayne beef? And I said, no, what the fuck are you talking about? Oh, it sound like he dissed you. And it's like, what the fuck would he diss me? And then the third person that called me, God be my witness, man, I was picking a nigga up from New Orleans, man. Shout out to Magnolia Chop, man. Shout out to Magnolia Pimpin', man. Wow. I was picking him up from New Orleans, from the airport. Mm. He got in the car with me, we ride. A nigga say, yo, man, it sound like Wayne dissed you on this song. I hung up. I said, man, that's the third nigga that called me. And my nigga from New Orleans said, oh, yeah, I heard that shit.
And you on Cash Money at this time?
No, I was off Cash Money. This is when I left.
So you digging. Right. This is Birdman sending.
I don't know what it was. But my nigga from New Orleans said, oh yeah, I heard that shit. That shit wasn't about nothing, though. I said, wait, hold on. He really did? Mm. So then I reached out to him. He didn't reach back. And then that's when I put the diss records. I was rap, man. It's rap, man. I never had no problem with Lil Wayne. It's rap. It's competitive. Oh, nigga, you think you better than me on the court? Go get your sneaks, nigga, and lace up. Mm. Let's go.
Definitely was going to challenge y'all in basketball. I'll be seeing y'all.
No, no, don't fucking do that. We don't play older niggas.
We don't play old niggas. Old niggas ain't got a shot. See my man over there with his shorts on. He ain't got a shot, man. He ain't got a shot, man.
We play the drunk Olympics, though, right? Like, we don't have Gatorade. We have champagne on the side. You know what I'm saying? Like, we play the drunk Olympics.
And I want to say something.
But let me go back. Let me go back to this before you please. So, but... what? Did you write Lil Wayne's Swamps? Is that true?
Man, that
or
shit.
Leave it alone.
Let me just say this, right?
Because that's, you know.
I done spoke on that shit so many times.
Right.
N.O.R.E.
Just not on this platform. That's the reason we want to get this out the way.
Well, if you Google it, Stunner said that out his mouth. Well, he wrote some things for the company, but he didn't get paid what he got paid. So that was gratifying enough. Mm. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, at the end of the day, man, salute to Lil Wayne, man. Salute, you know, salute to Baby, because I seen Baby in Miami at King of Diamonds, and, you know, I approached him. Mm-hmm. What's up? He said, what's up, Wool? I see what you're doing out here, Baby. I ain't got no problem with you, Baby. It's all love, so all right, cool.
This is when you started
the show? This recently. This is a couple years ago.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? I don't hint on no old shit. Shout out to him, man. Keep doing you, man. Shout out to Wayne. Keep doing you, man. Their past is just part of my story in life.
Yeah, that's what it is. The thing is, we can only fix our future.
Right.
We can't correct the past, but the past is a part of our past.
It's the journey.
Regardless of what?
It's the journey.
Good, bad, or ugly. You know what I'm saying?
Hold on.
Go ahead. No, good, bad, or ugly. Yeah, you ain't smoked this whole time?
No, because we can't smoke on our podcast because.
Okay.
No, it don't matter.
Okay.
I'm not good.
Feels so good.
That nigga smoke Reggie anyway.
So what made you be the guy that you don't smoke, you don't drink? You was like that prior to being in the
camp? Yeah, when he used to get fucked up back in the day, I used to make sure this nigga get home.
All right. But in jail, you ain't developed no type of habit?
In jail, we had 8 jobs.
Okay, let's get into these.
You ready to put some smother on back?
I'm telling the truth. You was a cook.
Yeah, I was a chef.
He called you a lifeguard.
Chef. You used
How
to
was
do
your lifeguard?
No, I didn't say life coach. He was a life coach.
I'm going to bring it down. I'm going Was you a cook?
I was a cook.
Mm-hmm. Was you did the outside work?
Yeah.
You was the captain of the wrestling team.
The fuck a wrestling team is this? He's lying on me, man. He's trying to give me some spicy shit. He already know it. He's lying. Noise. You know he's fucking lying.
They told
lying
me he's got a wrestling team. His name is Dick Flair. I'm just telling you what the niggas said. I'm just telling you what the inmates told me.
This nigga lying on me. This nigga lying.
He was pimping in jail. He had two O's. Ricky Minaj.
He's lying. He's lying. You know the name is even fucking yeah. fake. They don't know Ricky Minaj. There wasn't no Nicki Minaj out there.
Yes, it was. Nicki Minaj been out for 10 years.
You lying, man. He's fucking lying, though.
You know Ricky Minaj and Beyonce.
You see what I got on, right?
Beyonce.
You see what I got on, right?
He lying on
me. Okay. By the way, it's 4-4-4
right now. 4-4-4. Salute to Hobie Hope. I mean, he watched it over us somewhere.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, go ahead, continue.
If you're not going to own up to the shit, then I'm going to stop telling them.
What else? What other lies you got?
You wasn't a lifeguard in prison?
I worked in the shower.
In the shower.
Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here, man.
What nigga clean the showers in prison?
You got to clean
who
the shower.
Take that job. You see a thing like this nigga got to take out. You done yet?
No, when the shower's over,
I'm just keeping it real, man.
Right. Oh my God, y'all got me dying, man. So you never smoked a drink ever?
Never.
Not before prison.
Never. It wasn't my, like, a lot of my homies smoke wet. Like, sometimes he'd smoke wet, strip out his clothes. I had to fucking hug him. You remember that time? Yeah. He stripped out down McDonald's.
Yeah, I ain't gonna front. At one point, Philly used to get the highest ever. They used to smoke wet and drink lean at the same time.
That was him.
No way. What did y'all used to call that, wet and lean?
No. I used to drink lean. I ain't never smoked no fucking
lean. You smoke some butt naked and you stripped out at McDonald's and walked through the drive-thru. You walked through the fucking drive-thru like you had a car. I said, yo, I had to come get him, throw some towel. It was wild. Some crazy shit, man.
He put smut on my neighbor. It was crazy. I didn't
leave that shit. No, see, you know what the thing is funny? Mm-hmm. When I was in jail and I just see people.
Because most people I know, pardon for cutting you off, that didn't smoke or drink. And how much time you did? You did 20?
Yeah.
You did 20 years. Most people I know that did any amount of their time, they came home with some type of bad habit from being in there. Like, I know people who went there sober, came home with heroin habits.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It's a possibility.
You know, came home on methadone.
You know, like, busy,
you know what I'm saying?
Oh, no, the nigga got his habits.
Okay.
Oh, ain't no rap. We be driving in the car, nigga have a whole conversation with himself.
That's another story.
Like, I'm not even in the car, nigga be like this. I'm talking about talking and answering. So we supposed to go down there, right? Yeah, we supposed
He's
to go down there.
He's fucking this nigga.
Talking to Ricky Minaj.
What's this nigga lying on me?
Talking to Ricky.
This nigga lying on me.
Listen, Ricky. Ricky and Beyonce. Listen. Ricky and Beyonce had life.
Ricky got out. They got out.
No, they didn't. Oh, how you know he got out?
They got out. All of them. I just heard that.
They doing good on the streets.
They're doing good on the streets. You never indulge. Never.
No, that wasn't my thing. That wasn't my type of hype. You know.
But you had to do it one time to figure out what your thing.
I actually caught contact. My man Hype. I was in the car one time.
You're about to catch contact right now.
No, that shit is for real.
I get contact.
I was in the backseat of a Monte Carlo, right? The music blasting, right?
Why nobody get contact drunk?
No, this shit is different. That motherfucker was smoking some crazy shit, right?
Uh-huh.
It was my man Hype and Dude. No, it wasn't wet. They was smoking some strong weed or something. And they had the windows rolled up. They was playing some. It was either the Purple Tape or Survival of the Fittest, whatever. It was loud as shit in the back.
Uh-huh.
I get out the car. I'm just like, he dropped me off at Nanny House. I go up the stairs, I make it to the steps, I jump right in the bathroom, just start throwing up. Had me fucked up.
That sound like a bitch ass nigga to me.
From contact?
Throwing up, though?
Yeah, I was throwing up and everything. Hair was spinning back in the day.
That's a little extreme for contact.
Wow. It fucked me up.
Wow, and you never had the desire. Never.
Never. No, that wasn't my type of thing. After I see him smoke butt naked and strip out, I was done. I said, I'm never using drugs. You know?
Let's make some noise for Gillie getting butt naked.
Why are you making butt naked?
Y'all gonna stop the dumb shit.
So back to you, Gil. Yeah. You've been on these labels,
mm-hmm.
and you said Tony Draper was your favorite. Then you got this experience with Cash Money. It wasn't so great. What makes you say, I'm still staying in the game? Most people will say, you know what? I quit. I tried. It didn't happen. Let me finish. Let me finish. Let me go back and do something. What made you stay in the game?
See, one thing about me, bro.
You could have easily been like a mad rapper.
No. Let me tell you something.
Like fell into, you know what I mean?
99.9% of the people that would have been in my position would have already went and got a job at SEPTA, man.
What'd you say?
They'd have been driving. SEPTA is the bus that's ride through Philly. The trains
Philly.
New York Transit, whatever it is. My brother would have been one got a job somewhere else doing something else. You feel what I'm saying? But one thing about me, I always been in a limelight since a kid. You feel what I'm saying? I was the best basketball player.
He was a clown. You had the clown job where you played the clown on the weekends.
You feel what I'm saying? I was always the captain of all the teams that I played for. So I was always in the limelight. I feel like that I know that I'm really that nigga. It ain't no... When you got a certain type of confidence, when you met me, I had that confidence.
No, you did.
I ain't had no record deal. I didn't have no record deal. It was 1,000 niggas out there rapping for N.O.R.E. and Mike.
He told me you put him on. You did something for him.
Yeah.
No, I put him on the mic last
This is when I was in jail. Yeah. I was in jail. Yeah. He's like, you know, no, I see. You told me he did. Yeah. I don't know.
N.O.R.E. was down 15 with Susquehanna at a festival.
Yeah, exactly.
With Mike Lighty.
Yep.
And they pulled me into this motherfucking cypher.
He killed all the dudes in Philly.
And was just clear that the level of language was here and here.
Yep.
Mike from the gate said, man, give me your number. Call me the next day.
Violator.
Come up Violator. Mm-hmm. I come up Violator. I walk in the office. It's Fendi, Mike, Red Cafe, Gravy, and Q. At the time, they was franchise.
Oh, they was a franchise.
Yeah, they was franchise.
Franchise, yeah.
Coming there, Fendi. Mike say, this is what I was telling you about. Fendi say, let me hear you. Spit something. I rap. Fendi say, rap again. I rap. Fendi say, rap again.
Same verse, different verse.
Okay. I'm in the middle of rapping. Fendi say, oh, shut up. A guy named Black, who was my son's manager at the time, walking past the door. Fendi, I don't even know if Fendi knew my name. Fendi walked out the door and said, bet 5,000.
Oh, this is the famous you and Mike song battle?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
Fendi said, I gotta hear about this, because Mike son told me some shit.
Fendi said, bet 5,000. Black turned around, Black said, what? He said, bet 5,000. I got 5,000 on him. He didn't even know my name. I don't even think Fendi knew my name. Black was like, all right, bet it. As he's saying it, my son walk up. So, you know, my son is a little, you know. So he like, he want to bet 5,000 on him right there. So my son look at me, like, and say some slick shit, like, like, man, y'all going to have to do better than that or something. So I say, oh, you got me fucked up. So now that Fendi like, oh, this nigga got some heart like on that. It's like, let's fucking go. They get the whole Violator, Def Jam, everybody that's in the building.
Yeah, I heard about this.
We go all the way around like to this big ass conference room. As we walk into the conference room, you gotta walk past the elevators. Mm-hmm. As we walking past the elevators, that shit say, bing. It's Jay-Z and Dame Dash.
I knew you was gonna say that.
So now all the Def Jam go crazy. Violate. Oh, y'all gotta be the judges. We go in the room. It was the best 3 out of 5 verses. My son, you my guy. I love you. Only went 3 rounds.
It only went 3 rounds.
1, 2, 3.
You cooked it. The first 3 rounds.
It's a pig's pussy pork.
Okay.
That's my guy. I love you.
My song spit too now.
But I'm telling you. He did.
This is pre-jail my song.
No. Yes. This was right after my song beat Sean in the battle.
I set the Sean battle up. That was me. That was me.
That was
injustice.
I never seen it, but I heard about it.
That was me.
Like, he just beat.
Well, I just set it up. Hey, I bowed out. What happened was.
Shabazz, what's up, baby?
Hold up.
Mike Sean. Yo, we right here with Gillie. Gillie, this is your boy N.O.R.E, by the way. This is N.O.R.E.
Yes.
Let's make some noise for my advice. Gillie just said he had a battle with you. It was supposed to go 5 rounds, but it went 3 because he 3 zipped you.
Nobody ever 3 zipped.
Hold on, let me say that again.
Nowhere in the world, niggas gonna 3-zip me.
Now
you know that.
Yeah, and also, we're gonna get right back to that. But how did you and the you and Shine battle happen? Because I just took credit for it, but I want you to say it.
No, it was you. That's what I'm saying. That's why you wouldn't know of anybody. Ain't nobody just gonna 3-zip me and nothing.
Yeah,
I
ain't get 3-zip.
Like, it just don't happen to me.
Goddamn it,
Mike Song. Well, tell Mike Song I'm setting it up, man. I'm gonna get pay per view. The older nigga battles.
With a part 2?
Hey, listen, part 2. Listen, I had to call you because we right here with Drake Champs. I said, fuck that. I'm setting it up. I'm a Don King, you and Gillie. Part 2. We're gonna go get the sponsor. You're gonna get the bag. I'm giving both of you niggas 150 apiece. Best of 5 rounds.
I gotta get
I'm your manager. You're a deal manager. I got this, man. So now you got to get Mike Son down
both,
here to
managers.
Handle this, all right? You got to bring him down to Drake Champs.
Hold on, Mike Son.
Fizzy on the phone, Mike Son. Hold up.
I'm on Drake Champs right now. When I battled Mike Son in Def Jam, how many rounds did it go?
Hold on, let me see Fendi say something.
Fendi.
Hold on 1 minute.
My son just sat here and said, I lost the battle in Def Jam when Jay-Z and Dame Dash was the judges. That's a lie.
Hold on. Oh, can you give it to N.O.R.E?
Hold on, N.O.R.E.
Wait, what did you say, Fendi?
No, you got FaceTime, my son?
So who won that battle?
I'm FaceTime.
And how many rounds did it go?
Gillie won. I put the money up.
Woo! Okay, now.
I mean, the money would know.
Okay, now. And you got
that's big Fendi.
All right. All right, hold on.
Ask him how many rounds it went.
How many rounds it went?
It ain't going that many rounds. It might have went 1 round.
It was the best 3 out of 5. Remember, you said, that's round 1, that's 1-0, that's 2-0, that's 3-0, give me my money! They said, it's 2 more rounds left. Jay-Z said,
no, it ain't. My man in the red iceberg sweater won.
This was Jay-Z?
Yeah. Okay. Well, we ain't talking about it on Drink Chat, so now the case is done now.
Okay, thank you, brother. I love you, my son.
I would have got you. I had to call my man, my son.
But I cooked the shit out you, sir. I threw you on a barbecue grill with the Obey seasoning.
But Mike saw can rap.
He can rap his ass.
So I still don't see the 3 zip thing part.
Shit.
But I understand. Is that Mike saw?
Did he win a round?
Oh, wow. I got to see. I definitely got to come.
Let me tell you something, man. My vernacular is spectacular, man.
Mike Song! Yo,
you got 50.
You should put the 2 face on. Put the 2 face at all.
Hold on, what you say?
I saw you didn't win no round that battle.
He said,
I'm going to put the money up.
He said, my son, you didn't win a round that battle. He the one that put the money up.
My nigga, that's a lie. That's a lie.
Tell him, my son.
I want to correct it.
Put it back up.
At Def Jam, when Jay-Z and Dame Dash was the judge, you won?
No. I'm
not gonna lie. Oh, okay.
I want to correct it.
Hold on.
No, let's correct it. The Def Jam that we had, you won. Dame gave you the bad because Jason said he left. When we went to Bad Boys, when you lost, and you got mad because you lost.
You went to Bad.
You
went to Bad Boy and lost.
Oh, he said you won a Def Jam, but at Bad Boy.
You won a Def Jam, but you.
Okay. Let me tell you how this one at Bad Boy.
Oh, y'all battled twice?
Tony Draper bet $25,000 or $15,000. Puff bet $15,000. Puff said, who gonna be the judge? I said, nigga, you. This shit ain't gonna be close. Right. And then we won the first round, Puff said. You got that one. Yeah. The second round, Puff said. I don't know. I think my son got this one. Tony Draper said, nigga, Puff, you better stop fucking playing about this fucking money, man. That shit wasn't even close, man. You better fucking stop playing, man.
It wasn't. No, he wasn't. He didn't judge it. He make it. That's not what happened. The people. It was a whole room, motherfucker. Fuck, they not judging. It was a whole room for people.
Hey.
People
judging. You know who I'm gonna call? Tony Draper.
Please.
It was a whole room for. He make it.
Let me call Tony Draper, please. I love it. Love it. Thank you.
So you say you cooked him twice?
The second battle never finished because Drape said, Puff, after the second rap, that shit wasn't even close. When Puff sat there and said, I got to get at the mic, son. That nigga Drape said, nigga.
Let Mike son talk.
Put my son on the mic.
Puff, no. I told niggas that you can rap. I told niggas you hot. I told niggas that I respect you. I told niggas all that. I just telling niggas that I cooked you for the money. That's all. It ain't no knock on you, but I did.
Wasn't close.
No, it wasn't close, man.
No battle in the world would nigga battle me that I wasn't close enough. It never happened. A nigga never zipped me. A nigga never said... It's nowhere near close. That never happened. And never in a battle in the 40 plus years of my life has that ever happened.
Okay, now. Okay.
Well, listen,
now.
I'm setting up my son, Gillie 3.
Set it the fuck up.
Listen. I'm listening. Oh, this always ain't my son. My son. Listen. Hold up. My son. Hey, my son.
Set it the fuck up.
My son.
Hey, Smack, I'm going to break the shit out this nigga.
No, take chances and fall. Listen. This is what I'm going to do.
This is what I'm going to do.
Because
this
is what I'm going to do. Chips. I'm going to give y'all 50%. I'm going to own 75%
of the merch. Since you manage everybody.
I'm managing everybody. Listen, we're going to set it up. Look at him. He's ready like Rocky. Right, son? He's ready like Rocky. He's ready. I'm going to call you, bro. Keep doing your thing, bro. Hit me up. Love. That's yo, what that, I mean. I'm a promoter, man.
That was hard.
No. It ain't going to be no Philly versus New York. And I want to say something right now while we're here, because I got another pay-per-view. Jim Jones, Cameron, don't fuck with us. We'll turn Harlem into North Philly on that ball court.
Right.
We'll be renamed to Harlem North Philly on that basketball court.
Because let me tell you something.
Keep your name out your mouth, Jim.
Wait a minute.
You see that? They call me Ray Miller.
Hold on. Hey, Drake.
What's up, baby?
I'm on Drink Champs right now. Drake, can I ask you a question?
Absolutely.
When me... It might sound battled at Puff House. He won?
Fuck, no, you smoked the shit out of him.
Oh! Tony Draper.
Okay, now.
My son, my nigga, you smoked him.
Wow. Okay, that's two people. That's two people.
He's gonna call reliable two different
sources.
Incidents.
Reliable sources, two different jokes.
Draper, I said here, I said, Puff said, who gonna be the judge? I told Puff, you could be the judge. This shit ain't even gonna be close.
Absolutely, that's what I'm saying.
Wow.
After the first round, Puff said, Gillie got that one. After the second round, it got even darker. And Puff said, I gotta get at the one of my son. And Tony Draper said, stop the bullshit, nigga! Use a motherfucking lie. Did I say that? Is that what I said? Stop the bullshit, Puff! Use a goddamn liar! Okay. Hey, Drake, that's all I want, because I just sat and told that same story, and I said, Drake told...
Yeah, I'm here. What's going on, Drake?
We need him on Drink Champs.
We need your Drink Champs. I'm going to get your line from Gillie, if that's cool, when we get off air. Yeah.
I remember, hey, Jim, I'm gonna tell you a story real quick. I remember N.O.R.E had just got off Neil Levine label.
I knew he was gonna go tell a story.
I was in New York, I was walking past Justin. N.O.R.E had a motherfucking 550 blue thing out there.
Woo!
Happy as a motherfucker.
Gotta tell a story, Jim. That's right.
I was screaming out for That's right. My beard looks so sexy.
That's right. Real nigga shit.
They better get to the money now.
That's right. That's right, Tony. I'm going to get your math. I'm Gillie.
I'm gonna pass your bath off, Drake. Yep. Love you, brother.
Yep. Let's make some noise for Tony Drake.
Legend.
The one thing I don't do is tell no motherfucking stories.
By the way, I'm gonna be honest. That was legendary right there. That was legendary. I never heard of the second battle. I heard of the first.
Right.
I've never heard of the second battle.
It sounded like the second one was more legendary.
First off, I've heard of both of them, but I've heard it like it was one. I never knew it was two different instances. Yeah. So that was like kind of shocking.
Because after that happened, we went over to Daddy's house. We walk in, right. Puffin' there, Jennifer Lopez sitting on the couch. They start talking rap shit. And Drape said, man, can't no nigga fuck with my nigga right here. Mm. And then whatchamacallit said, man, I called my son. He said, he just killed my son at Def Jam. Mm. Puff couldn't believe it. He called my
because
son.
Because Puff was there when my son destroyed Shine. That's
right.
A fact.
He called.
I was there
He called my son right there. Mm. My son came over with 52 niggas over to the studio, and that's when it went down. But it
and
never
there's
finished.
There's no camera footage in this shit? I'm surprised. Man,
you know, back then it wasn't like that.
It was a camera.
I'm doing this nigga shit.
There's even little tiny footage of DMX and Jay-Z's battle. Like small footage of their shit. And that was in the early 90s. Right. You know what I'm saying? So
one thing about my son, that nigga was a beast.
Nah, he's
a
tough.
A barbarian.
No, he still talk that shit.
He's tough.
He got one of the best Funk Master Flex
freestyles ever.
That joke was legendary.
He fucked that shit up. Funk Master Flex freestyles. He fucked that shit up. Yeah, he could really kill that shit. So, I was agreeing with you on that. I used to pull it up. It was 3 years ago. He was by himself.
Yeah, let me see.
Killer with my boy Funk Flex on Hot 97. He fucked this shit up.
Off of the Welcome to New York City.
My son.
Yes, sir.
Everybody can't come up here.
Sir.
I got here, Flex.
He fucked this joint up.
He fucked this joint up.
Right. Yeah, I don't know.
That was what?
Let me hear.
This is one of the greatest Funk Flex ever.
I ain't never seen this. Nah, he killed it. He went fucking bananas on that shit. Make some noise for my son, man.
That's my nigga.
Good nigga.
And shout out to my son, man. Right. Tree the Truth, man. Right.
Everybody out there.
Shemika Mallory.
Mallory.
Until Freedom, everybody out there putting it down. They doing their thing.
I love the people that's on the front line.
They're on the front line. Because everybody got a part to play. Different people play, and they playing the part that they need to play.
They putting themselves out there.
Yes, they is. Yes, they is.
So now, this discrepancy that you are having with Joe Buttons, what is going on here?
No, it ain't really no discrepancy.
I just like to use that word.
Yeah, it's just that, like, with our platform, we don't talk about other podcasts unless we bigging niggas up, man. Mm. Like, because if we ain't bigging y'all up, then that come off as hate to me, right, man. Mm-hmm. Because why the fuck do I give a fuck about what y'all doing over here? Mm-hmm. Y'all can do whatever this y'all shit.
Mm-hmm. And y'all the shit come from left field because Gil, he was just on live with Gil, giving Gil 5-star props.
But do you think he comes from, like, the 50 Cent somewhat? Like, if he talks about you or if he goes at you, it's somewhat.
But what's the background? Because maybe not everybody knows the background.
No, this is the background. I never knew Joe. He know Joe.
Okay.
I think Joe was a bigger rapper than Gillie. That's our whole fight.
Okay. Oh,
Pump It Up was bigger than any song Gil had. Shout out to Joe Budden for that one.
That's hard.
Pump. I was just listening to that shit in the cell.
That's my shit. While a nigga was pumping you.
No, the fuck nobody was pumping you. But that's another story.
He
now.
Cell, pump,
now
pump,
this
pump,
what happened.
Pump me up.
The first time.
Pump me up, Ricky.
Listen. I'm gonna just say this. I don't want to put this up. Gil was in college creeping with this boy named Lil Him. That's another story.
Lil Him.
But that's another story.
Well, I wasn't ready.
Good. But so we go. We had the Roots picnic, right? They was on the bill at the Roots picnic for the podcast like 2 years ago.
Yeah,
that was the year after us.
Listen, we go there. We go there. Maul show us nothing but love. Give us all the game that he had on his face. Listen, man, y'all doing your thing. Shout out to
Maul. So y'all started y'all podcast?
We was already moving. We was always shaking it big and already number one. So he give us love, you know. Joe did some flaky shit, stepped off when he seen us coming. He dipped.
No, he don't drink.
I don't drink.
I ain't gonna drink him.
He stepped off, right?
Lee, get him water, please.
Yeah, listen.
We got water.
Listen, ginger ale or ginger beer on the rocks.
That's a shot, hold on.
Listen.
That's a shot, hold on. We're gonna do this together. This is a celebration, bro.
Listen.
We don't know. Hold on, finish your story. Yeah. We don't know if y'all know, but our show is about celebrating people here.
That's what it's about.
I ain't trying to, you know, be involved in no drama, no gossip, none of that bullshit.
Yeah.
I want to big us up. Everything we do on the shit that we go through, shit that we're involved in, we should be saluted. So that's what our show is about. You know what I'm saying? Salute, baby.
Salute.
Take that shot.
I ain't got nothing in my cup.
Come on.
I ain't got nothing in my cup.
You can't salute with water. You can't do it with water. It's bad luck.
Man.
Salute. You got watermelon cigar too?
Ain't nothing.
It's watermelon cigar. It's the freshest on the market.
That's what's up. I like that.
Who stole my Columbia White, by the way?
I like that drop. So on and so on, right?
I'm sorry, I cut you off.
Now, we go, he slid off, it was cool. But Maul gave us everything he could give us, all
Maul
information. Maul came down with our live shows, no bullshit, no deal. Because first of all, we gonna say this, it's not beef, ain't nobody getting killed, none of that. No, it's just about, you had something to say, cuz said something, whatever. So now, everything cool. Maul always showing us love, it was always, you know, a couple people say, you know, he will always show his shit about podcasts. Right. And no disrespect, salute you, Joe.
Right.
But we also, when we going to salute you, we got to salute Taxstone. We got to salute Rest in Peace to Combat Jack. Yeah. So we going to salute everybody in the space for creating the lane for everybody. We ain't no haters.
Right.
But
Ice-T,
everybody. Yep. So at the end of the day, it was like, he just came off. He was just on live with Gil. They was all cool. Then he just popped the
and
jaw.
And I saluted y'all.
And he told
me. On the live, right there on the live.
He saluted.
Ain't no ego involved.
Right. Ain't no ego.
Ain't no motherfucking, yo, man, shout out to Joe, y'all. You, N.O.R.E, Taxstone.
Right.
Y'all niggas set the
motherfucking. All y'all, man.
All of y'all. Right on live with the nigga. Front of my fan base, your fan base, ain't no ego involved.
Right.
So for you to turn around and go on your fucking podcast.
And what did he exactly say?
This is what he said. Oh, this just came to my knowledge. About a problem that was going on with $1 million Worth of Game and somebody that they cut off their show.
Oh, yeah.
But hold, dog, you and Gil just talked about this on live 2-3 weeks ago. So how did this just come to your knowledge? So it was some real, it was crazy.
And not even that. What really got me mad is that it's not even that you talking about me and my business, is that you had no facts.
No facts.
Like, nothing you said was remotely true. The nigga said, so well, I think they on episode 82 right now. With my nigga, we on episode 60. The fuck are you talking about?
We was like, on SoundCloud. Rui ain't talking about we was on SoundCloud. Nigga, we was never on SoundCloud.
Yeah, they started off on SoundCloud. It's just like, dog, what the fuck are y'all talking about? So it was never no, it's just that, okay, if I'm a sit around and I'm going to talk about some niggas, I'm at least
just
do some facts.
I just want to keep it even, and I'm not like I'm defending them. But they did the same thing with us. Like, we had them on the show because they was, you know, they disputed our numbers at CBS. And we didn't really get care, but I wanted to let you finish. I'm sorry.
So that's just a part of the whole program.
I believe it is. And I believe he has love for y'all. I'm going to be honest. I think that he wants to spar with you, though. You know what I'm saying? It's just like,
you think it's competitive.
Not that type of spar.
He thinks it's competitive.
Yeah, we can put the gloves on tomorrow.
But that's also a sign of respect.
But one thing about him.
Also a sign of respect. Look what you just said, Gillie. When they refer to my son, right? Hold on. All right, let me see if you finish.
Come on, champ. Come on.
That's your manager.
Get the fuck out of you.
I gotta get that
manager. That's how you always try to stick the manager.
I'm trying to get the manager. Fuck that.
But you notice how you said, you said, You said, Mice On. You said, yo, I cooked him. You said, I beat him in both battles. But then after you said that, you said, but Mice On is nice. So you know why you said Mice On is nice? Because you want your enemy. You want your enemy to be on the same level. You don't want your enemy to be a sucker.
No. Because so I respect Mice On.
Right, I was about to say.
And I don't want Mice On to take it in the wrong way. Dog, you my brother. I respect you. I love you. I'm talking about some shit that happened 20 years ago, and I'm telling the truth.
No, but what
I'm
saying,
that's nothing disrespectful or nothing. Right.
No, I'm letting it be.
No. I fuck with Mice On. Right. That's my nigga.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? It's not. I'm not sitting here talking about Mice On personal business.
Right.
I'm not sitting here talking about some shit, Mice On finances and what he didn't do and where Mice On record out of and none of that shit ain't got nothing to do. I'm talking about some shit that actually happened with me and Mice On.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying?
So, well, what I'm saying with you and Joe
other niggas there and I can call.
Say is, I feel like it's like an ego thing, meaning like, yo, let the enemy be a tough enemy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Because if you win that war, then it's great. If you win against a sucker, you don't really get props for that. You know what I'm saying?
Well, if he wasn't to a certain level, I wouldn't even have responded to him.
All right.
So, you know, you got to pick your battles wisely. You feel what I'm
saying? That's what I'm trying to say.
Right, absolutely. So
you get my lighter just because I think you're trying to steal it.
The fact that he on it. You got a lighter right there.
I know. That's why I had to be clear about it.
Lighter collector.
I'm getting my lighter because I just don't want to
old nigga shit.
I don't want niggas to look at the... You know, my fans are collecting.
No, he suffered from OPS, man. Old people shit. Collect the lighters. Give me off lighters.
My fans be like, Gillie, thug him out. I see him take the purple lighter. So, you know, you got to keep it even. All right, okay. Thank you.
Honestly, with me and Joe, it's not even no beef. It's just we both live in a space now where it's a media thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's a media thing.
And none of us do the same thing.
None of us do the same thing. I don't give a fuck if we did the same thing.
Right. It's enough money.
The only person I got in competition with was Elliot Wilson. And I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not a fucking saint. But Elliot clearly started with me.
Bruh.
He really started with me. Like, and he. Like, go ahead, bro. Come on, you can smoke.
Ellie.
You can smoke, buddy. You can smoke, baby. Come on, man.
Ellie.
But that's Ellie. Only he. What happened, and this is how you turn it all into competition. What happened was, I got word that Birdman flipped on The Breakfast Club. Because all three of them, it just hit me for some reason. It was like, yo, wait till you see our Birdman interview. It's 27 seconds, but it's crazy. And I'm like, all right, cool. So I hit Elliot. And I said, yo, I know the fact that Birdman is out there. I can get him to, because he wants to do an interview. You know, they thought that Drink Champs was in New York. So his people was hitting me. So I was giving Elliot Birdman. I said, yo, listen, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you Birdman.
That's a major play.
In New York, because I'm going to go get Wayne. And I was trying to start my own shit. But whatever happened, the shit Birdman didn't happen. So I figured when I threw Elliot the bone, he would throw me back a bone. So he had Leor Combs on his show. And all I said was, yo, let me get Leor email. I didn't want Leor as a guest. Leor was my CEO. Like, we made great money together. And he was like, for what? I lost my mind, nigga. What you mean? I'm N.O.R.E. Not to be cocky or nothing.
I like
that. Not to be cocky or nothing, but if I ask you for a first fucking contact, pass the fuck off, man. Because that person who given that contact, he ain't going to say who you got this from. I know too many people. Right. But when he said, why you want his contact, I just took off.
Don't ask
I couldn't
that.
Believe that. I couldn't believe. So he turned it into a competition thing. But other than that, none of us do the same. Like, I heard you bring up Tax Stone earlier. I want to address that. What Tax did, no one else is still doing. So if Tax come home to this day, his lane is wide the fuck
open. Right
up.
Yeah, he'll pick it right up.
There ain't nobody that's doing something that another person is doing. I watch y'all shit. I watch Joe's shit. I've watched every shit. And everyone is pretty much original.
Right.
Original. Even the locks right now. The locks is original right now. I'm watching they shit. I'm like, oh, okay.
Because podcast is personality.
It's personality. Right. No one can personally be like you. Right. I mean, there's people that's cop. Don't get me wrong now.
Right. Yeah.
I love my copyists out there, boy. I go and I like they shit too. Mm-hmm. When they be copying my shit, make some noise. They got drinks and all that. I'm like, look, nigga.
Well, everybody had drinks after you.
Mm-hmm. But I don't mind because I know I'm doing the right thing. And like, for a lot of people, like, you know, I want to address something. Because Ben Baller responded to a fan. He didn't come at us. He didn't come. And what he said was, a fan was like, yo, this is the second week in a row you said something about Drink Champs. One day he had said something, and then the fan asked him again, and he was like, well, oh, but you know, we bigger than Drink Champs. Let me just explain something to everyone that was out there. Everyone that's out there.
Talk heavy.
I just,
I just want people to know.
Talk, Kev.
You're competing with 6-day-old product when you compete with Drink Champs.
Talk, Kev.
We are a television show. We stopped being a podcast. Yeah. That's okay. Y'all. We gave that.
Talk heavy.
Go, bro, brother. Whoever got that position, go, bro. We don't mind. But we let off with Revolt. Revolt came to us with a wonderful deal. Mm-hmm. And we knew we was those dudes that would be there. And I knew I could talk to Puff, even though he's crazy as shit. Don't get it twisted. Yeah. Puff stepped to me on Thanksgiving one day. He know he's out of line. So, but I knew I could work with the bro, and I knew the bro won't fire me. So, because trust me, these other deals and these other places, we were offered these deals. Mm-hmm. But you know, we wouldn't have had that freedom to do what the fuck we want right now. Can nobody tell us to put out a fucking cigarette? If I'm, no cigarettes in here. Right. Deuce, we looking at you. They got my brother Deuce, man. I told you. But no one can do that. And then we brung in Jay. Because we said, they ain't in competition. Puff and Jay is not in competition on this level. This is a subscription-based site. And then we brought in Nas. And we made the most...
Mass appeal.
Yeah. And we brought the most... And see, so a lot of people judged us. So I wanted to respond to Ben Baller. Because he's like, you know, I'm doing bigger than... And I like Ben Baller and big, and I actually respect him. But you got... Whenever you say something and I have to defend myself, that's actually called a diss.
Absolutely.
If I have to defend myself on something, that means you dissed me.
Absolutely.
So maybe you didn't know what you were doing by saying, yo, yeah, we're bigger than Drink Champs or whatever. No, you're not, because if it wasn't for Drink Champs, probably you wouldn't exist.
Absolutely.
So how could you be bigger? And you're talking about an audio space. There's nothing.
Audio, linear, audio, YouTube, digital.
If you put it together, we got linear.
Subscribers.
We got subscriber base. Like, and we're not in competition with nobody. We don't want to be in competition with nobody.
No,
in fact, I salute y'all being number one in that motherfucking iTunes audio space. That just made me, pick you up.
Yeah.
And you know what? We got out of that space. And if it's, for lack of a better term, because I'm trying to stop saying this word, but if it's other niggas in that space, we saluting that.
Yeah,
I'm like, go ahead, nigga, because now the inmates is right in the building for real.
And I'm going to say this. You just gave me some information, because he know I'm information man. But I like the way you did that, like the other space. And it is other people in that space. Shout out to Mano. Shout out to Big Facts Podcast out of Atlanta. Yep. Shout out to everybody that's doing their thing and running it up, because it's enough. They don't never stop printing money,
Wallo,
man.
I'm going to tell you something. When we started the podcast, we realized that people were giving their YouTube away for free. They would sign for audio.
Yep.
And then give the YouTube away for free.
They actually asked. CBS was like, okay, let's do YouTube. And we're like,
nah.
What deal do we have?
We got hip-hop already. We knew what
time
deal
was. What's the contract?
So check it. So we started to notice that all of these dudes that was on, what's the shit that...
I know what you're talking about. I know what you're
saying. I forget that label they was on. They was all on this shit.
Loudspeakers.
They was all on it. But you signed a loudspeaker.
He from Philly, too.
Loudspeaker because, you know...
Nah, yeah, they're pioneers in the podcast.
Combat Jack was over there.
Yeah, they're part of it.
Really, we knew that in hip-hop. We knew that audio was one thing. Video is something. Video in hip-hop, you charge me to make me look good, and then I got to pay that back. So we was already on point, like, man, the video part of... If you notice, Drink Champs, our first 6 months, we never even put out videos.
But we were filming.
Yeah. So it made our clientele go up, and then we start putting out clips, and niggas is like, what? Jada Kiss talk about Suge and Eve? Like, why the fuck? Where's that footage at? And then we got Shabba. Remember we had, not Shabba, I said Shabba. Damn, man, you know what I mean. Shaggy. And all these videos never came out. So it built our catalog. That's why they hated us in the podcast game for a while. They loved that we went to television because we told these dudes, oh, YouTube ain't free. Oh, our YouTube, when you want to see us,
right,
you got to pay for that.
Right.
That was
That was legend.
We did that. We changed that in the game. Ian, give me a high five, brother. Come on, brother. I know you don't brag.
No, but
sometimes you got to drop your nuts.
We did that.
There's another component that I think we're still fighting for is that the whole data-driven part of it,
right.
Fuck all that shit, because we split our data into three different, like, release platforms.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So then each platform looks a little weaker because we're split.
Yep.
Right. Because people did what you're different.
Right, yeah. But what we're fighting for, and this is what I think we all need to understand, is our brand is right. is important it's to one, these platforms. Right. Yep. They want us, but they're going to use our data against us.
Yep.
Right. But our brand is bigger than that, even that data. Yep. Because right. when the we're audience, doing different yep. things, you know what I'm saying? Like right. if you're on social media, you this, you that, you're going to split all your data. Right. You know what I'm right. saying?
Right. Right. Because somebody might, they just want to see your video.
We just got to know our yeah. value and right. hold yeah. tight and say, nah, man, fuck that. You want yep. Drink Champs? You want this? You want that? Yep. Pay accordingly and let's move forward.
And what's crazy about our deal is that...
And God bless y'all as bar stools.
What was crazy about our deal was that I was only out of prison 31 months. And
damn, I ain't gonna lie. 31 months. How many years is that? I'm sorry. Come on.
31 months.
You still counting shit like prison. Oh.
No, come on. When I was out, when I signed the deal,
you had been out 31 months.
I was only out of prison for 31 months, uh-huh. and I turned down $1.8 million on an email. Like, no, I'm cool.
Okay,
like, because I knew work. There was so many people coming at us. Mm-hmm. And I said, hold up. We're keeping our tour. Mm. We're keeping the merch, mm. a large part of our merch. If you're going to manufacture and fulfill it, all right, cool. We're going to bust it down with you.
Right.
Mm. But and it ain't got nothing to do with Gillie and Wallo. What Gil do, that shit ain't got nothing to do with us. Mm. We dealing with $1 million worth of game LLC, our corporation. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's what we're going to do to deal with it. But we're going to keep this. And when it comes to ad rev, we get majority of the ad rev.
Right.
Way
yep,
more.
Yep.
So, and we own our IP.
Right.
So it was a lot of shit that, and this dude, only thing I did was I was just reading out, what's the name game? When I sent him a link from Spotify, because we was playing games. Shout out to Maurice Correct. He told us to, he used to call us 8 week, y'all niggas better stop playing and start a podcast. Maurice yes, Correct. And
Maurice Correct,
he's at Ohio State football.
Let's do another shot.
Listen, they used to do that. So I sent Gil
gonna bring the homie in too.
An article from Spotify when they gave out $400 million in the first 4 months last year. And he said, nigga, and they was talking about how the podcast is taking over, it's gonna be stronger than music, all this other shit. I said, nigga, this one I was telling you. And I started sending 1,500 articles that I read. I'm sending videos. He like, you read all this? I'm telling you, I know the game. So now when we walking in the room, we throwing our motherfucking feet on the table.
No, remember, I don't want to set him up. No.
We walking
this cut right here. This is a cut.
Listen.
Oh, he already got
it? We walking on the
room. Oh, he asked it. Okay.
We walking in rooms.
I don't want to trick nobody in the drink.
We walking in rooms throwing our feet on the table.
This is not Lamar Odom. See, fellas?
Oh, shit.
You see everybody? Listen,
you're not tricking nobody.
I ain't tricking nobody into, listen, I hold the camera. This is not what happened. Mr. Lee almost bought a shot, and while I will not trick you into drinking,
I ain't gonna drink that.
I
got more
than the audience, because you know, I got blamed for some shit I ain't had nothing to do with.
Lamar Odom blamed you, right?
The world blamed me. What do you mean?
You laced his joint. Oh, he's
not. No,
laced his joint.
Wait, no.
Spray going there.
No. Let me leave it alone.
We're gonna get the truth today, guys.
Let me leave it alone.
Let's get a little truth, sir.
Let me leave it alone. Hold on, give me a shot glass at, bro, because I'm thinking I did that now. That's the way you said it now. I'm just like, but go ahead.
And what's crazy is this, N.O.R.E. A lot of people don't know that you don't have to go to a podcast outlet to get the super bag.
Mm.
You go to a liquor company. You go to a sneaker company. You go to
so let's break down y'all guys' deal. Barstool Sports.
Barstool right. Sports.
What happened? The reason why we was able to go in there and get a great deal is because we was already making money. We already had sponsors.
So y'all was independent?
Yeah, we was independent.
We went our first 10 months,
God damn
8
it.
Months.
God damn it. Y'all took the blueprint and ran with it.
Yeah,
God,
eight
God damn
eight
it.
Months.
Our first 8 months, we was independent. Okay. From our second
show. They got our story. Look at them. They got our story.
Yeah. From our second show.
I ain't gonna lie. Listen. In real life, this is not it, but in park, y'all little homies, right. man.
It's love,
I'm proud of y'all. I'm proud of y'all.
We salute you.
That's crazy.
We sit here and say thank y'all.
And I didn't, listen, I told you to do a podcast, but I didn't give you the platform. I didn't give you the breakdown of how you just did it. The fact that you knew what to do that's honorable. Okay, continue. So 8 months, you independent.
Eight months we was independent.
Wow.
You feel what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
From the second podcast on, we had sponsors.
Wow.
Look, N.O.R.E.
You feel what I'm saying?
We didn't. Y'all did it better than
we
us.
We had car dealerships.
Slides, we do that, so hopefully you ain't had
6 months we had.
This is what happened. No. We do the first show. I'm in Salt Lake City with wifey. We laying up in Salt Lake City.
Utah?
That's my favorite place in the world.
Wait, time out, sir.
Salt Lake City.
Wait a minute.
It's peaceful.
Wow. That's your Kanye? It's your Kanye?
Yeah, basically. This before that.
Are you warning?
No, listen.
This fucking Kanye.
I'm on this. So listen. We dropped the podcast, right?
Nigga wanna be? I just love Utah so much. Even the niggas that play for the Jazz trying to get the fuck out of it.
I love it, though.
I just love it so peaceful.
man. It's extraordinary. Outstanding. But listen, so I'm in there. I'm the dude that's always on shit. So I hit Gil. I said, we dropped the podcast, and like 2 hours later, we was like number 11 on the charts, right?
Wow.
He said, what the fuck? I said, listen. I hit him back. I said, listen, I got a nigga out of San Antonio. He got a trucking company. I met him at a real estate event. He got some bands for us. He won a sponsorship. He said, bring it on. Okay, let's get that. I'm talking about this is when it first dropped. The first day it dropped.
This is not Barstool Sports.
This no. Us. It went to number 2 in comedy and number 4 out of every category on a podcast. Woo. And I'm talking about within hours of it being released. Woo. And then after that, we just start being number 1 all the time. So what I'm doing is I'm telling Gil, come on, put your jewelry on. He said, what? I said, here go this paperwork, read that. What's that? A sponsorship deck. I already got it done up. Come on, we walk in there, put all your fucking jewelry on. We ready to go get this bag. So we going to different places. Shout out to Springfield Hyundai.
I'm loving this.
Listen, shout out to Springfield.
Man.
So yeah, I go in the joint. I think
it's sponsored by Hyundai. Right?
No,
y'all got some car dealership.
My shit.
Y'all be selling all type of
shit.
I ain't gonna lie.
Absolutely.
Shout out to Danny's all.
You be making
shout out to Springfield Hyundai.
Yeah, you got a good manager, man.
I'm the nigga with the brain.
All he know is this. When I call that nigga, he fight with me all the time. When I call him, I say, Gil, put your jewelry on. We got to go somewhere. He know, this nigga got the bag. It's the bag time. So we'll pull up. We'll leave him with a check. Got a W-9 and everything ready. I said, don't worry about nothing. So we go in there. I'm telling these people. I say, listen, different sponsors. They're like, all right, so what are we getting? I said, I'm going to give you 8 minutes. I need 20,000. They said, what you mean? What's that? And it always be a young person. And all these corporations and brands is a young person that understand y'all power and analytics and all
culture,
that.
Yeah.
And they like, yeah, it's worth it. I said, what are you going to do for that? I said, I'm going to give you 2 minutes. We do 4 podcasts a month. I'm going to give you 2 minutes at the beginning of the show where I'm going to blast your shit, your number. I'm going to throw your logo up on there. But I'm telling you, I'm going to make noise for 2 minutes, right? For 20 grand. I need 8. I'm giving you 8 minutes. They told me, so where do we sign up? I said, well, we only do 6-month plans. Mm-hmm. We can't really, because we got other people that's trying. Okay, no problem.
No. We start off with a 3-month plan.
Listen.
Shout out to Springfield Hyundai, because after the second month, they called us the fuck up and said, fuck this shit. Yeah. We want to do a forever plan.
Listen.
Wow.
So Springfield Hyundai. We just sold the most fucking cars we ever sold.
Y'all
giving
away too much games.
But no, we got to educate.
But we educating the youth.
And then I come to him, I said, you don't even need your jewelry. I already got this joint. I mean, I got this one.
Hold on. So basically, what he's telling you is, he's my worker.
No, I'm a manager. No,
that's what nigga go work for.
The money go. The money come to me.
Get out of here.
He said you're his Ricky Minaj.
Hold on.
He's a hoe.
How Black Young said, get up, you little whore.
I got to listen. All the money go through me first. He don't know I be. No, Gil, we just got out of the bands.
He's skimming.
We just got out of the bands. I'm down kicking these niggas. We got 175. We got other bands here. So listen.
So I put that fake call into
his PO. I called him one time.
Hey, try to drop some weed off at your crib with a fake call into your PO.
Oh, no, they ain't about that weed.
He's selling weed out of
this.
He's
selling weed out of
this. Are you still on parole?
Yeah, I'm on parole.
To 2048.
To 2048. But we working on that.
On you.
Hold on, God.
October 29th, 2048.
You gotta get away from us.
No, y'all cool. We cool.
No, I tried to avoid this comment. What was you in the can for?
Two armed robberies, 2 firearm violations.
No.
State of Pennsylvania.
No, okay, can I tell you what he said? When he was really in jail for being.
Hold on.
No, I need to tell you the truth.
Okay.
He lying.
For being slow. Everybody else got the fuck.
No, this what happened.
He always a nigga talking about
this. What happened? I'm gonna tell you what happened.
Take his back leg. Scraping shit off the ground.
Listen, this never happened before.
He get locked up.
This is what happened.
Yeah, he slow
so 20,
shit.
They got Gil. They got Gil, and Gil said, Wallo, get from under that red car. They got us. And they booked us. He told on me. Made a 20-page statement. Gilly's a rat. Gilly is worse than 6ix9ine. He iced me. I had to put it out there. He got this.
Put some sweat on my fucking
head. Don't worry about it.
We got the worst editors. Listen. They made people distrust me. They do
shit. Don't worry about it. I don't give a fuck about that.
Not the worst editors. Yeah, I'm talking about the people.
All right, but listen.
Someone give me a knife. I'm going to stab this.
So you want parole till 20...
Yeah, it's possible. 2048. 2048. Yeah, because I had 19 and a half to 52 years. I did 20, came out, you got to walk it. Pennsylvania is like this. If they give you 5 and 10 on the back, they mean you do 5 in, and you can come home. You can. They don't owe you shit. Parole is a privilege, so they let you come home. So that's how the game go.
But, of course, they let him out when he's supposed to get out. He had 8 jobs.
But that's another story. Now, listen, let me go back to this, because I don't want to get this off. And I want dudes to understand it because everybody want to be in the podcast kid, they understand the business.
Right.
The weirdest shit I ever came to Gil about is when I came to him, I had the bag, a crazy bag. He said, damn, I said, this is a little different, cuz. He said, nigga, you ain't even call me. I said, I ain't had to call you. We got a funeral home sponsor. He said, a funeral home? He in the crate, smoking, he said, what the fuck are we gonna do with a funeral home? I said, listen, this girl is extraordinary. She make the body look like they still living in the casket. So listen, no bullshit, N.O.R.E. She gave me the shout out to Aisha, boy, funeral home out there in Kansas.
I wasn't ready.
So listen.
I'm sorry, bro. I wasn't ready. I didn't know where you was going.
Listen. So listen.
Fucking me all the way up.
This when she come back and tell us. I said, Gil, she want to meet us. Mm-hmm. We go meet her. She said, listen, this shit got to stop. I said, what's up? I'm getting too many bodies. She said, y'all got my fucking funeral home rocking. And then she said, now I got other funeral homes hating on me because I did some shit nobody ever done on this.
I still wasn't ready.
Listen.
You're still going.
Listen. So it was just like, let me just say this. If you got a podcast out there you're trying to get, stop looking at, you can get the girl with the hair salon, the girl with the boutique. Anybody can give you bread to sponsor to run ads, but you got to know how to pump ads on your shit. And get sponsors, you know what I'm saying, N.O.R.E? That's all this shit is about. A lot of people don't understand that, man. But I got this nigga Rich over here.
Oh, goddamn, man. Make some noise for your manager, Rich. Man.
The manager. I mean, the negotiator.
All right, Samuel Waxman, get the fuck out of here.
You know what I mean?
The fucking negotiator.
Yeah.
Nigga, you get me to the rubber, I talk my shit.
He don't say nothing, I do all the talking.
20 years of experience.
Put your jury on, nigga, and shut up. Look like a rapper.
You believe that? Hold on. Before this nigga been locked in for 20 years, I did deals with Cash Money.
It's very true.
Suave House.
Ooh. Very true.
Warner Brothers.
Ooh. Very true.
Rough Nation.
Ooh. Very true.
Tom Bahali. Koch.
Oof. Okay.
And
you a journeyman rapper.
You want these niggas to believe you getting in.
He's a journeyman's rapper.
Get the fuck out.
He's a journeyman. You ought to get a journeyman boxes. He's a journeyman's rapper. He's washed up. And he's really mad. I'm gonna break it down. He's mad because Baby was a bigger rapper than him.
You know what?
Baby was a bigger rapper than you. That's why you left Cash Money, you bum ass rapper.
I'm a nigga.
He's Joe.
No, you know what?
Joe was a bigger rapper.
You know what?
Joe
was bigger than Gil.
If we don't know one thing,
Joe's song was bigger than Gil.
If we don't know one thing, we know this. I'm a nigga that know how to get other motherfuckers to write a check.
He know that.
Mm. Make some noise for that.
Make some noise for that.
I'm a nigga that get other niggas to write a check.
Yes, he do. And we go back and forth. I go in and he be sitting there with his jury on quiet. He sit there quiet, got the jury on.
You go on to his jury a lot.
Listen, don't, because that's important. When you walk in the room, they got to understand that, nigga, we ain't broke.
Wow.
Right, yeah.
We ain't broke.
It's psychological.
He go in there, he sit there, he chill. I go in there and start running the stats and all this, then a third. Then he start talking that deal language. And then our lawyer come in and clean anything up. We taking this out. Here you go.
Because, Gillie, you do speak like a Goldie. You do speak like you got, like, pimp.
He's a simp. He's a simp.
No, let me tell you something. Because back in the day, I was something like a pimp.
You was something like a pimp.
Before I met Tootie.
Yeah.
I had hoes like cable channels.
That's your girl, right?
Yeah, before I met Tootie, I had hoes like cable channels. Right. Y'all understand what I'm
Absolutely.
Saying?
Absolutely, you had a lot.
I had channels. HB, I had an HB hoe.
I don't even know what that means.
To make a nigga Showtime. And a bitch love running with the stars. You hear me? You might catch the bitch on Eat Like Joan Rivers, and she loves smoking Nick at night. And for the right price, she'll let you explore with her asshole like the Discovery Channel. This bitch will suck your dick so good, you'll give her a Bravo and an Encore for a motherfucking lifetime. And she only stopping to come up for oxygen. They think with this bitch is a BET, that's a motherfucking bet.
So before Tootie.
Before Tootie.